Ciao Juventini of the world, my name is Giuseppe, welcome back on the channel. It's Monday, an important week because it will lead us to two big games. The first one on Wednesday versus Dinamo Kiev in Champions League and then back to Serie A. Serie A without Morata, but a derby. Derby means two clubs from the same city that will play versus each other. We will play versus Torino. Big game as always. So we had the disaster weekend, 1-1 versus Benevento. We already know, we spoke about it so much. And that's why today on Monday, I want to go to the Italian and international papers to see what they are saying about our beloved Juventus. As usual, and you know it, I want to start with a lot of rush news. But again, if you are new to the channel, you love Juventus, you want to be informed and entertained every day about Juve, about the black and whites, consider to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to put a maximum of like. This should be standard. We put a like and then we watch the video. Guys, comment everything that you want because I read them. I read and I try to take some time in the day to answer a lot of them. We start with a few rush news. The first one is I want to say happy birthday to my friend Abdul Latif. He knows who he is. He's watching the channel. He's my big friend from social media since years now. He's 33 today, the year of Bernardeschi. 33, the number of Bernardeschi. And Abdul Latif is celebrating his 33 years. I want to say happy birthday to him. And then we go to a special thanks to all of you guys, single by single, one by one. Because yesterday during the live, we hit 9,000 subscribers. 9k, phenomenal, it's incredible. I would never have thought that we could have reached these numbers. Again, the first year, for people that knows me, I have put a target of 1,000 subscribers. We are already at 9,000. Incredible. I was taking these numbers, thinking about all of you, every single of you, and thinking about Belgium. One of the biggest concert rooms in Belgium is Forêt Nationale. The capacity is 8,400 people. So we are already 9,000 people on the channel. That means that even Forêt Nationale in Belgium, where they are doing sport events and music, it will be too small if we want to reunite all together. Thank you for this, really, really, really. And then the last rush news before going into the front pages, because we will talk about Chiellini, Khedira, Pirlo, we will talk about all of this, is that it's still Black Friday. Today it's a Monday, we call it sometimes Cyber Monday. We still have up to 30% on Turin's Finest with the t-shirts, No Pirlo No Party, Inter Merda in two colors, and then we have the Gigi's Juve t-shirt, Juventini of the World, the t-shirt of the channel. So if you want to enjoy up to 30% on these t-shirts, you have to go today, guys, today. And now we go to the front pages with Gazzetta dello Sport. Are they saying something about Juve? I'm always curious when I open them and I look at the page. No, they are not. They are speaking about, and deservedly, about Milan, because they are first with plus 5 points. We will go through the ranking in a second. Then they are speaking about Maradona Insigne, because yesterday Napoli won 4-0 versus Roma. Shocking result. I was not expecting that big difference because Roma was in form. And then Miracolato speaking about the Formula One driver that get out of the fire in a miraculous way, thanks God. So we will not speak too much about Gazzetta. Corriere dello Sport, are they speaking about Juve? No, again, they are speaking, ha vinto Maradona. Maradona won, because yesterday a crazy Napoli won 4-0 in the name of El Pibe de Ora, Maradona. Guys, comparing Insigne as Gazzetta is doing with Maradona is a bit exaggerated again. But yesterday they had a special shirt, special made between a mix between Argentina and Napoli, the two big clubs of Maradona. Was quite beautiful gesture. More than this, I don't know. Now it's still exaggerated, Insigne with Maradona, but it is what it is. The ranking we have have to talk about the ranking. Why are they speaking so much about Milan, about Napoli, about Sassuolo, Inter, blah, 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 and not about Juve? It's because we are fourth. We are fourth at 6 points from Milan. Milan has 23 points, followed by Inter with 18, Sassuolo 18, Juventus 17 points, and Napoli 17. Don't forget Roma with 17. So after actually Milan, that is going really, that there is escaping from the group, we have Inter, Sassuolo, Juve, Napoli, and Roma, 5 teams with 1 point difference. So nothing is closed yet. A statistic, guys, it was since the season 2001-2002 that Juventus didn't draw 5 games in 9 total games. So that's a lot. To be honest, in 2001-2002 we did even worse, with 5 draws in 8 games. So that's really long time. The good news is that in that season 2001-2002, Juventus was still able at the end to win the Scudetto. Scudetto number 26. So please keep having faith and hope. Last news about Milan, market related news, is Donnarumma yesterday was speaking about the fact that he will stay here. He didn't sign the contract yet, the extension on his contract, but he really see himself at Milan. If Milan continue to perform like this, if they will go in Champions League, I believe that Donnarumma will stay, because he's waiting for that moment for so long. Yesterday again, a really beautiful Donnarumma, by the way, beautiful performance. I watched the game. Sport, they are speaking about Juve. Finally, Diego, che notte nel tuo stadio. Diego, what a night in your stadium. Speaking about Maradona, makes sense. And then in fuga, escape from Milan, again, also deserved title. And then in the right part of the Tutto Sport, they are speaking about Pirlo in Riga, queuing with a small title that are actually saying, I will read them. Pirlo ha dato la scossa alla Juve, ora dovrà lavorare duramente per un cambio di mentalità e per trovare una leadership alternativa a quelle di Ronaldo. Pirlo spoke and used really hard word to wake up Juve. Now he will have to work really hard to find new leadership when Ronaldo is not there. Leadership, a world that we will speak a lot about today. And then we go inside to the sport with a few articles, really interesting, one more than the other one. We start with the first one. Sveglia Juve, così Pirlo può svoltare. Wake up Juve, in that way Juventus can change and go back to the top. So the first thing that actually he's saying is the fact that at the moment we miss leadership. We miss a lot of leadership. These were the words used by Pirlo. Unfortunately, that is one. And then we have problems in the midfield because we are creating too much density. Only one goal from the midfield with Rabiot. That's it. And we still have no alternative to Morata and Ronaldo scoring a lot of goals. So these are ways to work on it. Also, the mentality, psychology of the team will be really important, because we have to work not on Ronaldo, Chiellini, Buffon, but especially on some players like Ramsey, Bernardeschi, even Kulusevski. These players has to grow up mentally, become really stronger. And even if we speak about the Arthur Rabiot, they have to step up in leadership. Leadership that we are missing a lot now. And then we go into who can be the possible leaders of this Juve. Probably De Ligt. De Ligt is more and more a leader in that young new Juve. I will say it really honestly, maybe a Juve that is missing a bit of balls. It is what it is. So De Ligt is still more leader, and he showed that he can be really the leader of these young men and probably even of the team. Juve Info France is speaking about another leader that can come back really quickly, and it is Giorgio Chiellini, that is still training really hard and can be on the bench versus Dinamo Kiev. Really great news, because we need that leadership. Morata fa per due. Morata is not a leader, absolutely not, because we know it. When Morata has a difficult time, it's not always easy for him to go over that momentum, so he's really thinking about himself and he's doing it right, but he's living a magic moment at the moment, because his stats are crazy. When you go into an average by season of 15 goals per season, he can double it. If he continue in the rhythm that is busy at the moment, thanks to the trust of Juve, that thanks to the trust of the management, that thanks to the moment he's living, he can even go until 30 goals in a season. Let me know in the comment, do you think that Morata can hit that 30 goals in that season? Let me know, yes or not. And then we speak about another leader that eventually essentially is sending some signals saying, hey, I'm here, it's Sami Khedira. Sami Khedira, an article about him, of Tuttosport, who is actually questioning themselves, why not Khedira? Why not playing Khedira? If you need leadership, if you need a smart and intelligent man, why don't give him a chance? My opinion, guys, no. No, it's over. I know that Khedira yesterday, he spoke. He said, I have no problem with Pirlo. I understand the moment, but I am available to play. Thanks. No, please, we move on to other players. Please, 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 please. And Fabrizio Romano yesterday, because there was a big confusion where Sami Khedira reported by ZDF said that he's interested in the Premier League, but he will not leave Juventus in January. Actually, it was a fake because it was his brother Rani from Augsburg in Germany who said that he didn't want to leave in January. So still an open door for Khedira to see him far away from Juventus. Again, guys, for me, it's still until the end, fino alla fine, supporting the players that are part of Juve, but Sami Khedira, for me, is already not part of Juve anymore. And then we finish with the last news, the news about Mercato, with Lovato, a player from Verona that is playing regularly now in the defense, young player of, I believe it is 20 years old, 19 or 20. Juventus is really interesting in him. He's a center back. They could do an offer of 20 million. They even have an advantage on Inter. So Juventus can be really consistent in signing that new player. Will he join Juventus immediately? Probably not. It will be, you know, the kind of deals when Juventus buy a player, they park him in their actual team for one or two seasons more, and then hoping that the player has continuity, can grow and join Juventus in the future to grow that Italian-based players of Juve that we need at the moment. That was it for me, guys. I hope you will have an amazing Monday, an amazing week. Don't forget, new to the channel and you did it until the end of the video, thank you for this. Subscribe, hit that button of like for you as a new part of the channel, or old ones, loyal ones that I still love, hit that like button. Thank you. Forza Juve.